much more geared to encouraging residents and visitors to stay longer in a particular place. So that's my message. We did, I mean, there's lots of other things we could do with car parks, but the key thing is we do need to be more flexible. We do need to look at opportunities that we could take that would both help the local centres and maximise the revenue for the council. Thank you.
There is no real evidence base as to the impact of either increasing parking charges or lowering parking charges. So when I ask questions of our officers, what's the impact of all this here? You know, we've got a whole range of competing policies here. So, you know, we've got a policy of encouraging people to get out of their car and use public transport. So that's a big priority for us, which we're signed up to. You know, we're just coming through, hopefully we're out of it now, you know, a very difficult economic recession. Has that reduced the number of visitors going to shopping centres like casual? Why do we charge, so the gentleman, Mr. Hussein raised the question, why do we charge some car parks and don't charge for others? When I asked officers, what is the evidence base for the impact of either taking free after free away or putting it on, there is no evidence base. There's been no evaluation. Okay, so we are in a situation where, frankly, this whole policy area is a complete and utter mess, which is why we asked the scrutiny committee, which is why we asked the scrutiny committee to actually take a strategic look at this whole issue. Let's look at good practice elsewhere. So, you know, involved in the monitoring of let's look at some other areas. But I think, my recommendation, Mr. Mayor, is that we need to allow the scrutiny review to complete its report. I understand that's quite imminent. And we then need to look at the recommendations from that scrutiny committee and make a decision. But again, you know, I think it would be premature to pass this motion tonight until we see what the scrutiny committee are looking at, because they have been looking at all these strategic issues over the last few months. I think that would be the sensible course of action. So I would move that.
Okay, if you could be very brief, both the next two speakers, Councillor Watt and Councillor Dowdy, and then that's it.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Just half a minute. Congratulations to Councillor Fury on his maiden speech. Congratulations also to Mr. Hayes, Mr. Hussain, for his petition and for the points he's raised. Mr. Mayor, colleagues and I predicted that the dramatic increase in charges, including the Westfield Concourse car park, would be counterproductive, and so it has proved. Reduced usage, reduced revenue, more displacement to nearby residential roads, and reduced footfall for our local shops. Mr. Mayor, this council should cut charges and bring back free after free. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Yes.
Welcome to the views of that group. One of the important
if that's what all members think is going to happen with the evidence presented tonight, I think that would be a sensible route for it to go. I think that's what you were indicating, Councillor Hodgson, as a way forward. So I think that the motion should read something along the lines, we refer the evidence and petition to the task and finish group in good time for its final report. So it becomes part of the evidence based on that. I'm asking the question.
Sure, can I comment on that? I, as chair of the committee, meeting with one of the officers to report back and meet again as a task force finish group this coming Monday at 5 o'clock. So, just a recommendation.
So, we could combine with the sense, I'm trying to get agreement here. They'll just be able to present petitions to us. As I said, if it disappears or doesn't get any action to it, that's what I'm trying to make.
In fairness to the other traders groups across Wirral, I just want to point out that peasant traders, I want to say that I agree with every word that Mr. Hussain said, but they did have a look at the report that the task and finish group had sort of put together, but they hadn't actually agreed it. Peasant traders did get to look at that. What I would like is that the other traders groups have equal.
Sorry, it's not my job or your job to tell you how to do this business. But I know they work extremely hard, I've been extremely, they turned up a number of meetings. I'm wishing to make progress. Is it agreed that the evidence and the petition presented tonight is presented to the task and finish group in good time for the final report to be approved? That would be accepted by all. Is that agreed unanimously?
Agreed.
Thank you. Moving on. Okay, moving on to item number four is a question to Councillor Adrian Jones, which has been received from Mr. John Brace, or Mr. J. Brace, I think it says. Well-being, positive. Please still make statements. No. Okay. So the first one is that of the leader. Can I also remind of the rule that the questions have to pertain to the contents of the report, more or less. Is that good? Okay. Moving on. So this is the questions to the leader, and will be a maximum of five. No, you didn't. Okay. You look like it. Okay, we only have three questions. I'll hop a bit in the tree now. Okay. You want to ask all the questions and then the leader can reply. Councillor Green.
Thank you. Question to the leader. First of all, can I congratulate him on being confirmed as the chair of the Mining Authority? Please go out to see Labour leaders and stop squabbling amongst themselves. Would the leader join me in welcoming this is the Buckingham City Region Group deal announced by the government on the 7th of July, which will see an additional £153.2 million funding coming to the region? And would you also agree with me that the government has created more jobs because they've backed small businesses and enterprises with better infrastructure, low job taxes? There are 2 million more private sector jobs and 400,000 more businesses. That's 2 million more people than were with security or paying packets. Would he agree, also agree with the OBR forecast that the economy is continuing to recover and recovering faster than forecast? Growth this year is forecast to be 2.7%, the biggest upward revision between budgets for at least 30 years, which means the economy will be £16 billion bigger than forecast 4 months ago. And would you also welcome the delivery of best skills training, and that there have been over 1.8 million new apprenticeships in this parliament, giving young people the chance to learn the skills they need to get on in life, whilst also taking the pay packets each month? And would you therefore agree with me that it's many calls for the government to change course were wrong?
That's a simple question, Councillor Blakely.
Thank you, Mr. Wall. Thanks. Get the achievement. My question to the Council is regarding the whole notion we've got to go since I've accepted and will comply with authority. The leader refers to draft long term road strategy. However, sadly, we see no mention of what's been the town of the station more. And we just heard the leader extolling the virtues of policy getting people out of cars and public transport. So, Mr. Mayor, will the leader of the council therefore ensure he gives equal efforts in trying to secure this long awaited station as he does the other way through against the outline of his report?
Councillor Stevenson.
Mr. Howard,
draw
my question.
Oh.
increasing, improving access
to Liverpool City Centre. The freight and logistics hub building on Superport, which is a key economic scheme for the city region, getting freight moved from the port of Liverpool, getting more. 90%, I heard a statistic last week, which is astounding, 90% of the imports from India go through ports in the south of England, and 60% of that freight is consumed by communities and areas in the north. So we need to win more of that business back into the north, and I think the money that's going into the freight and logistics hub within Liverpool, the port of Liverpool, will be an important element of that. Low carbon energy, another key project, and of course we have a major player in the Canaleras and the offshore wind sector, and creating the city region investment fund, providing that scene called capital. So I do welcome all that. I have to say, on a slightly disappointing note, I think it's a shame that the government didn't support the concept of time before. I think he would start arguing for a massive and radical decentralisation of devolution of power. I think it was the funding he wanted involved in Whitehall was about 49 billion. George Osborne's agreed 2 billion to be involved. So it's a pity that Mr. Osborne didn't take full amount of time's advice, but it's a move in the right direction. We need to do a lot more. I obviously would agree that the economy is now booming and all our problems are over. I think the economy is booming, but it's booming in the south of England and London. It's not booming